Anyway, we'll start. So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to my talk show. I'm your host, Owen Rebel. This is my talk show, Late Enough Rebel. And we have a returning guest here, Genocide. What's up, dude?
Howdy. It's been too long.
Yeah, it actually has been. It's actually funny. It's cause I can't even put your Twitch name in my title. Won't let me.
I know, because it's quote-unquote TOS. It's whatever, okay?
Yeah, man. No genocides allowed, bro.
I didn't choose this life.
You ever thought about changing your name? Like GG something
all
else?
All the time. But it's a little too late for that. Everything I've done on the internet since like 2014 has been this.
You never know, man. You never know, man. You might the Twitch police might come knocking one day and be like, bro, what is this username, bro? You trying to get a partner?
That's
denied.
True.
They'll be like, change your name first, bro.
Oh, I didn't even think about that. You know,
they could, yeah.
If I have to change my name, I'll probably change it to something to do with my OC. Like, we gave her a name finally on New Year's, which is like the 1 year anniversary of the model, because I got her on 2018's New Year's Eve.
Yeah.
So
2 years.
We decided to come up with a name for her finally, and we named her Violet. So I think if I had
there
to change
go.
My name from what it is now, we'd go with something along those lines.
Okay. I get what you're saying. So what have you been up to since the last time we talked, man? Like, you just been dancing, having a good time, the wan-wans, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. A lot of dancing. I've had to take so many breaks from dancing and streaming and VR chat altogether in like recent months. But I'm actually back now, and I have been for a little while. So, I mean, I've had time to kind of get my feet back on the ground and start running again and start practicing more stuff and actually improving dancing instead of just staying at the plateau that I was on.
Yeah. I hear you saying.
That's about it for like the internet side of things. Real life, though, that's been wild. All kinds of stuff going on there.
Oh, yeah? You want to talk about it? Or
a lot of big changes. Well, let's see here. Where do I start? Okay, so recent months, I had another major death in the family, so that was kind of a big hit to morale and put me out for like a week or so. I just didn't really talk to anyone or do anything. But I came back from that and kind of regrouped. I got out of a bad job that I ended up getting into. And ironically, I went back to a company that I worked with before. But I'm making like 60% more money than I was last time I was there. So on that front, it's been really good. Like, things with work have been going really well. When I last switched jobs, I really got myself into a financial hole, and it was an obscene amount of stress. Don't change jobs unless you have to or you have something else for sure. Fun fact. But with the new wages and stuff that I was getting, I was able to dig myself out of that hole finally, and a couple things started to take off really well. And then, coming back to that company, there's been a lot of like big changes with streaming and like personal life, because the hours and stuff are completely different, and it's taken some adjusting, and I think I'm finally getting leveled out with it. Like, I'm able to actually stream regularly again instead of once a week, if that, which that's been really good lately.
Okay. Do you remember the last time we talked? Like, in-game?
In-game, aside from the show, or just in-game in general?
In-game in general.
Yeah. We had a battle.
Yes.
Including anime girls and
yeah,
such.
Yeah, man. The waifu wars, bro. You know what I'm saying? I summoned
some waifus
to fight your waifus, bro. I ended up capturing you or something. I don't remember. Something along those lines. I'm a winner. That's basically it.
Yeah,
something like that.
Something didn't go well on my end in that whole situation. In my defense, I was shorthanded.
Oh, well, that's just called an excuse to me, buddy. Get wrecked.
That is hurtful.
Hey, man, it's okay to lose sometimes, man. You just gotta
You're
do
not
better.
Wrong.
Sometimes. Oh, shit.
It's best that way sometimes.
My full body is dying sometime. Don't worry. Anyway. So, since we talked, it's been a while, obviously. Do you have any plans for 2020? New Year's resolutions, any plans for, streaming more, big events,
That
subathon,
is one of
charity?
them.
Well, let's hear it.
I still have a hate boner for subathons. That has not changed from the last time I was here.
Okay.
But I do have plans to stream a lot more. Things have been coming up off and on over the last year and a half that I've been streaming, and they've been kind of disastrous hiccups for me because some of them have put me out for like a month or longer than in the time that I've been streaming. So I've only been streaming for about a year and a half now. And I'd say probably like 6 months out of that, I've been gone because I've been DDoSed before. Just events that occurred IRL that needed me to just back away from everything. Which really sucks because streaming's kind of like my escape. It's my way to vent, to hang out with people and kind of get away from things I have going on IRL, because sometimes it gets to be a bit much, especially this time of year. It's a little crazy and it just keeps me out of my own head, you know? I feel like a lot of people take other people for granted, and I've done that a lot in my life. I've shut a lot of people out and I've held a lot of people away thinking that it would help me, and it did the total opposite. It just completely destroyed me. So I've finally accepted that I need other people to be me and, to be happy. It makes life so much easier when you have people that you can talk to about anything, spend your time with, because time's the most valuable thing we have. And I mean, you got to use it wisely and use it where it really counts. And for me, using my time is with family. Whether that be the little bit of family I have IRL or my family on stream, on Twitch. I try to be as personal with everybody as I can and try to have like an actual down-to-earth relationship with everybody because, I mean, all of them truly matter to me. Everybody does. Like, if someone takes the time out of their day and spends hours with you several days a week, that's a big commitment to make. I mean, and it's. You end up building all these relationships with everybody, and they just become a part of your daily routine, a part of your life, and then next thing you know, you love them. I mean, you just can't let them go. And that's kind of how it is for me. Like, it's. Streaming's a very big part of my life, just in terms of keeping me sane at this point.
I understand, man. I feel that way with streaming sometimes, that like I stream just to escape reality. If I'm having problems in real life, I just put on the headset, click on the stream, and just sort of have fun, do whatever I need to do, whether it's interviewing people or hanging out with friends or whatever it would be. I understand that, man. There's many challenges in life that happen unexpectedly, and we have to deal with them. And sometimes people deal with them in different ways. Some of them deal with it by streaming or playing video games. So that's what I do. I mean, I don't do drugs. I don't really drink. So how I cope with life is
Same.
I play video games and streaming VR chat of all things. So
Yeah, it's dancing and streaming for me.
yeah.
My escape, the best thing I've found for me at least.
Yeah, 'cause I think like I got full body now since the last time I saw you. I got a new outfit. I don't really dance. I dance like a boomer. I don't have any I don't have any dance moves. Many people will make fun of me for that, but that's just the way it is. I also don't have any play space. Like I just don't have enough room. I literally can only front face. If I turn around, the whole thing dies. So I need to move out and get
Feel
in a
that.
bigger space. I'm sort of just can only do like the Orange Justice barely, and that's about it.
Hey, that's all you need to be able to do. As long as you're having fun with full body, you don't need to dance and stuff with full body. Yes, it makes the most out of it, but
Yeah.
I mean, as long as you're having fun with it, and I mean, honestly, I think it's a really good thing for the interviews and stuff because it kind of completes the setting. Because, like, if you're there in desktop, you're going to be sitting like this or something. And it's just like, okay, it's a little weird. Why is our legs in the chair?
Yeah, you look
Until
at
that
me now, my
happens.
full body's like literally dying.
Yeah, your hip just yeets off into the darkness, and then it's bad news bears.
Hold on. Scoot closer here.
I should,
Please. Full body, please. Hold on. I'll put the camera, I'll fix this. Dude, what happened? Oh. My calibration just like went off to the right when it shouldn't. I'll fix it. Takes 2 seconds.
I don't know if you guys have noticed, but Rebel's got a pretty cute pussy.
Oh, thanks.
Hey, no problem. I'll know if I see.
Hold on here. You just stand up straight. Access to what?
Your butt. Interpret that how you may.
Sure. Anyway, I think I fixed it or fixed it somewhat. Anyway, that happens sometimes. Full body's jacked up, you know how it is. Anyway,
Yeah, it's a
what were
struggle.
we talking about? Oh, yeah, coping with streaming and life and things and playing video games. So. I guess another question I can ask is, your outfits have changed, your avatar has changed over time. So, how do you,
A lot.
your outfit has changed a lot, man. So, walk me through it. Like, what's changed, man? Like, what's been going on?
Okay, so last time I was here, I had next to no clothing because that's what I've been used to for a long time.
Yeah, what's up with that?
Well, hear me out. I don't have a good excuse, all right? I got nothing. But anyway, I decided that needed to change because I got tired of being half naked. So I ended up getting my grubby little hands on the inventory system. Yes, I know it's unoptimized, blah, blah, blah. But I usually dance in worlds with very few people or by myself, so performance isn't really a big deal to me.
Yeah.
And I do have more performant versions for when I am with, a large amount of people, but I use the inventory system now to where I can cycle through a bunch of different outfits and have more freedoms with clothes and stuff because
Yeah.
it kind of sucks when you're only stuck with one specific outfit for a certain thing. Like, if I'm half naked and my milks are hanging out and I'm trying to dance to NF or something, it completely takes away from the entire emotion of the song if I'm just sitting there like, shaking everything off. So I wanted something where I was fully covered for once.
Yeah.
So I ended up getting a full like long sleeve hoodie and these here tights and all that good stuff. So I had a nice fully clothed like winter-esque outfit. And
Yeah.
then I wanted something a little more like lightweight and like summery, but not as revealing as like the G strings and stuff you see in VR chat nowadays. So I ended up with this, which is like my little summer crop top shirt, and it's got my little bra thing on it, and I got some shorts for dancing.
Damn.
I
Hell
also
yeah.
have a this thing tanked up. I know, I've just tried to add a lot more personality to it, 'cause like when you finally settle on an OC and you establish it, you have to do a little bit of building around it
Very
and
large
adding more
personality.
personality to it. 'Cause exactly. So that's kind of what I've been doing with like the outfits and stuff, just trying to add more to the model and just to change things up some because it gets so stale so fast. Like the very first iteration of Violet is unbelievably different than this one. Like I could change to it really quick and show you guys just how much this model's changed since the very beginning. So here's she's also freakishly tall now, BT dubs, but this is the whole
Oh.
outfit and stuff now. And
How
then
tall did you make your character,
she is 5'11". I made
Oh.
her my height as well. Because she's like 100% scaled to my body.
Okay.
Like, my knees here, foot's here, elbow, even the top of my head is where the top
of my
head is.
Yeah, but you thick like the IRL or what, bro? Come on, let's ask a real question.
You haven't seen my thigh pictures? Unbelievable.
Nah, dude. But,
like, literally everything, even my butt is where hers is. So it's a little weird, but you know what, it is what it is. Okay.
Alright.
Alright, so let's show you the very, very, very first one. Let's go way back to December 31st, 2018. This here is the very first version of this model. This one was a gift originally from my friend Harry, who,
Oh, yeah?
He did a lot of art for me in the past, and he got tired of me using public avatars, so he's like, I'm gonna make you your own model. Mm-hmm. And you're not allowed to use unoptimized ones anymore. So I was like, okay. And then it grew on me as I used it, and eventually, like all things, you want to improve it, because her booty's a flat tire, she's got hot dog legs, and...
Of course.
You know, there was a lot of improvements to be made. So, over time, experimenting with outfits, and after a year and a half of making my own body for her, I finally fell on my idea of, like, the perfect version of her, basically, in terms of her body and style, basically. So, I've ended up on...
You're just a blue man for me, what the hell?
I apologize, I took my glasses off, so I feel, you're the only one with glasses now. I didn't want to take that from you.
Okay. Yeah, I remember this one. This is the one, it's kind of similar to the one that you were interviewed in. Not quite, a lot
yeah,
less clothing.
Except that one was,
Oh.
That was this one.
Yeah, I remember now. A distinct difference. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, I
lots
remember.
Of skin.
Yeah, I remember now. I remember.
Yeah, it's
I think it was a smart move.
I do too. I've enjoyed it a lot. I actually being fully clothed on VRChat is such a rare thing that people actually really enjoy it when you are.
Yeah.
Like, what, you got clothes on? I'm like, yeah, ain't that crazy.
Imagine doing 119 interviews and not having clothes on till now.
That's it. Manka. Somebody's guilty.
What do you mean? I was just wearing my mechanic outfit. Just, you know? Yeah, man.
Somewhere that is out of place.
Nope. It's the same outfit that Sydney wears in Final Fantasy 15. So if you're going to ban me, you might as well ban Final Fantasy 15.
That's true. That's a very good point.
Exactly. It's all about context, my friend. I was just talking to people. I wasn't doing anything.
That's true. That's true. That's
it's
true.
Also for, it's also very my true. Outfit for role-playing, so... I mean, there's that as well.
See, there you go. See, it's not provocative. If people can get on Twitch and paint their naked bodies...
Yeah.
We can be anime girls somewhat loosely clothed.
Yeah, but now I'm clothes because it makes more sense.
As long
sense.
As it's not provocative.
Now it makes more sense. Now I got clothes on, yeah.
Yeah, now you look like a redheaded Fiora from League.
It's because it is.
That's true. I mean, you got the scarf and everything, though.
Yeah, exactly.
I
just
respect
stole
it. That's a great choice, honestly.
I also got it made from scratch, so there's that as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's nice that you have that consistency across all your models. Like, you go to the same person for all of it. I do the same. I made the body and stuff for my model, but the clothes and all that have been made by my friend AC Chosen.
Mm-hmm.
And he does it all from scratch as well. So it's nice to have that consistency across the board. Mm-hmm. Like, not having to use used assets or borrowed assets. Like, my shoes are borrowed, my ears are borrowed, and the tails are borrowed. That's
mm-hmm.
it. Everything else is completely made from scratch, so that's
yeah.
a good thing.
Yeah, I get what you're saying. I mean, a lot of people just have to deal with it, right? You can't find people that can make stuff from scratch. It's difficult, so I get what you're saying.
Yeah.
If you like, for me, I just have a standard of I have to get everything from scratch. It's just the way I am. If I have to pay extra, then it's worth it to me in the long run, right? Because I don't want to run into that situation where, like, well, if they like hunt me down and be like, bro, you're getting sued because you took this asset or some shit. You never know, dude. I'm always I'm future-proofing myself, so I set the standard I must get everything from scratch. So yeah. I can't settle for secondhand. I know many VR chat streamers don't care and they do where they want and whatever, but for me, I have at least standards, so.
Yeah, I mean, it's our avatars are kind of what represent us, you know?
Yeah.
Like whether or not you see them as like a separate entity or you see them as you, like you're the same as me. You see your OC as its own separate thing. It's
Yeah.
not you, it's your OC. And
Exactly.
I'm in that same boat, so it's like I want to see her how I want to see her. And other people see their avatars as them. So I mean, that's kind of like the wall between where, you know, expectations and all that are, I guess.
Exactly.
It depends on where you fall there.
Do you think that if you didn't change your outfits and like cover up, do you think you'll get in trouble later on or currently in 2020?
I've never thought that I would get in trouble for anything in particular. I know there's risk to it to an extent,
Yeah.
but I don't know. It's like the rules of Twitch swing so rapidly that it
True.
really kind of like blurs all the lines. Like there's a lot of things that can go fine, and then there's that one random thing where they're like, oh nah, you can't do that. So I mean, that whole half naked thing was kind of like a you know, maybe that could end up in trouble, you know, at some point down the road, but it was never really a main focus or a pushing force behind me wanting to, you know, get a bunch of different outfits and be fully clothed and all that stuff. It's really risky for me because of what I do. I really don't do a lot of provocative dancing. A lot of people will just go on and say like, oh, hip movements is like lewd dancing and stuff, which is
Yeah.
completely not true. That's not how that works whatsoever. But people will still say that, and I mean, if you're wearing like underwear or short shorts or something, somebody can get the wrong idea, and you know, it can rustle somebody's jimmies.
Of
But
course.
at the same time, dancing is kind of like body art if you think about it. We are using muscle memory in our bodies to perform, to entertain. And at the same time, on this platform, people are literally naked.
Yep.
IRL and can paint their bodies and you know do whatever. So if I'm dancing with a crop top and some booty shorts or a thong that completely covers everything, not like a G-string like or you know most of the public avatars nowadays,
Yeah.
but you know something that definitely covers me, that shouldn't be a problem. I understand there's a lot of like hate towards the whole oh thotty avatars thing, and I understand that. It is over the top in VR chat. But I mean, it's VR chat. Literally, we're anime girls, okay? So I feel like people kind of get way too into what other people are doing and care a little bit too much about something that shouldn't matter to them. Like, you can get on here and you can literally do what you want. If you don't want to see something, you can block. If you want to be something, you can be it. If it's not there, you can make it. And that's what that whole freedom's there for. So if people want to use the same public avatar with as much clothing as putting 2 pennies on your milks, then that's fine. Block them. You don't have to see it. That's kind of how I feel
True,
about it. I mean,
true. But
I've had.
I think the whole purpose of like the argument was that it was being shown to like underage kids and shit. Like imagine being 12
That is
and you play
true.
a game and you're like, oh boy, oh VR chat's a really good experience. And they load it up and then just some like half
Exactly.
naked girl
You know,
like,
I've
yo
seen that
bitch,
happen
what's
too.
up bitch? And you're just like,
Oh,
what the
yo,
hell?
bitch!
Whoa, what's go what whoa whoa what's going on? Like. That's happened one too many times,
See that? I.
or
Yeah.
it's people streaming that as well. So then you have like some 20-year-old with those avatars that literally cover nothing, and they're like talking to some underage kid. Like, what, you know what I mean? Like, come on. So.
Yeah, I definitely see the issue with that. Because, I mean, actually, just about a month ago, I ran into that exact situation. We were in the Black Cat, or whatever that world's called. And
Yeah.
there was this little kid in there, and someone came in with this half-naked avatar, and he's like, ah! Instantly! And I'm like, ah, oh, man. But it's unavoidable at this point. It's just the meta. If you think about it, VR chat rolls in waves. It's a place where you can be yourself, but everybody wants to be the same. Like the common population of this game. If you think about it. Every so many months, there's this new public avatar or base or something. This new wolf girl that gets super popular, and it's the only model spread across a bunch of public worlds, and a bunch of people are using in public. It's everybody flocks to that one avatar, and it's like a fad. And then a new base or body comes out, like this new one, with the big old chunky disproportionate thighs and the ears that are laid straight back. Everybody and their grandma is using that model now. And they just completely left all the other ones in the past. So it's like everybody's going to move in these waves with whatever's cute or popular at the time. And that just so happens to be that 99% of those are half naked. So it's like it's just
Yeah,
the meta of VR chat.
I understand it's
As
a
unjust
meta,
as that is.
and it's popular, but like you got to think about the bigger picture here. Like when you see everyone using those models, not just about like, oh, just block it from your view. That doesn't stop people from doing it. The bigger picture here is like, if that's the meta and everyone does it, then the game will get banned off of Twitch. So then you and I cannot stream this game anymore. And option
Exactly, and that
B,
was mentioned in the past
or it just
because of
turns
stuff
into
like that.
Second Life. So it's just like, oh shit. So
Exactly.
that's the bigger picture.
And one of the big problems with that is a lot of people. Now, see, this is kind of where it gets a little, fucky wucky. I use dancing and streaming as a way to cope and a way to, just express myself. A lot of people do. And the problem comes where people try to replace reality with virtual reality. People want to stay inside. They want to date specifically in VR chat. They want to just replace real life with this game. And it doesn't work like that, but they try to force it. And then that's when you run into these groups of people who are catering to the problems that you're mentioning. Like, the over-sexualized avatars and stuff like that, that's all kind of strewn into that. It's not a direct cause of that, obviously, because, they're just in the game. People are going to use them. But I feel like a lot of the main issues with this game come from that particular group of people. Like the crashers and whatnot. The gangs that were a big thing last year. It's all people who kind of like injected virtual reality into their real lives. Like they just tried to replace it. And it goes on this power trip and everything else. And that's where a lot of the toxic side to this game really get to show their colors. And it's ugly, honestly. And it makes a lot of people shy away from it. It runs a lot of older people off. I mean, you've been around for a long time. I know, I'm pretty sure you said you were around in 2017 as well.
December of
That's a long
2017.
time. And I mean, I've been ran out of here several times because of stuff like that. And it's getting to the point where this game has like this specific, what's it, demographic. And it's aiming now. I mean, the game is listed as, for some kids and stuff like that. Younger ages too. But the actual demographic of it is moving way up. Like, it's just gonna have to lose that title because there's no way they can control it without completely just snipping the beans off of the horse. You know what I'm saying? If they get rid of the creativity, VR chat dies.
Well,
But if they don't get things under control with the ratings and stuff, VR chat dies.
mean, I'm gonna tell you something. A lot of people make this very, very wrong assumption. This game actually has no rating. If anyone ever has told you this game is rated X rating, they're 100% wrong. This is an online experience. You cannot rate an online experience. The ESRB, which rates every video
That's
game in
true.
existence, they do not rate online
It's a social
games.
experiment.
Well, it's not that.
Or
What I
a
mean, it's an
social
online,
simulation.
it's an online experience. So if you were to play, for example, I use the example Call of Duty. When you play Call of Duty and it says M for mature and it says 17 plus, what they're actually rating is the single player experience, because the single player experience is the exact same experience every single time you play it. Every player will have the exact same missions, exact same cutscenes, blah blah blah. You can rate that on the blood, the gore, the guts, whatever's going on. When you play an online video game, the experience changes. And anytime that I remember as a kid playing Halo, any online Gears of War, doesn't matter what a game I played, it would always say online experience will change because you cannot predict what people are going to say or what going to do. When you play VR chat, you can
Yeah.
load into a lobby and have a G-rated experience where everybody's friendly, nobody's cussing, nobody's saying any curse words. You can literally go to another lobby, it can be 18 plus, it can be 13 plus. There's no way to rate this game by the ESRB. So this game,
Exactly.
when people say this game is for 13-year-olds, they're actually wrong. When they say that, you have to be at least 13 years old by law to own an email to actually play VRChat. That's what they're saying, is that you have to be
Yeah.
13 to have an email address. But obviously the average kid would lie about their age and just say they're 18. Anyone could just drag the thing down and say, I was born in
Exactly.
1985, and then play
Yeah.
VRChat. So technically speaking, I guess you could say you have to be at least 13 to play VRChat, because you have to be 13 to own an email address, which is stated by law in like every country, or at least the majority of countries. But the problem stems from the fact that a lot of just publics, like or well, the whole issue of why this is happening is because there's no moderation, if you really want to know. These
That
avatars
is
will
true.
still exist, and the mods of VRChat don't seem to do anything unless it's like strictly like actually nude. They'd be like, oh yeah, let's ban that. But if it's like questionable, they're like, eh, whatever. Like, I don't know what they're doing. I don't work for the devs of VRChat. I don't know what they're doing. Nobody knows what they're doing. It's a constant issue that it's always brought up in Twitch, on Twitter, YouTube, in the Discord. But there's radio silence from the devs, so we have no idea. And the problem is, the problem keeps rising higher and higher and higher. But there's no response from the devs, so we don't know. If they actually cracked down and said like, hey, don't use that avatar, you get fucking banned, kid. They'd be like, oh shit, all right, let's not do this anymore. But also the problem is, if you
Yeah.
get banned, you can literally just make a new account in less than 5 minutes and repeat and upload the same avatar.
Exactly.
So
See, that's the thing.
that's the
The
problem.
devs, they really don't have any power. Like, I'm not gonna get into many details, but I'm really close with a lot of the moderation team and developer team, and I have been for years. And the honest fact is, they just don't have as much power as they should. Hello? Are you good? This is why you don't buy index controllers. They're
Uh-oh.
junk.
I literally just ordered them.
Anyway,
Coming
you poor
tomorrow.
thing. Yeah, they won't last long. But anyway,
Damn.
clients. One big thing on this game that is a raging issue. And a lot of these clients give just as much power as the devs have. Some of them even more. This game's just so loosely thrown together in the state it's in now. When they pump 2018 out, things will change.
Yeah.
And that's their primary focus right now. They can't control things the way they should be able to in their own game in the state it's in now. That's why everything's kind of being pushed to the back burner for the time being. It's noted, but they can't act on it because they can just be overpowered. It's simple as that. Ban evasion takes nothing other than another email. IP bans. That's a meme nowadays because there's a billion things you can do to change your IP or get around that. There's just really no solid way they can handle anything as it is. And they know that. They've been fighting this uphill battle since clients first started becoming a thing, and they've lost every time. So I think that once we get into this new version of VRChat, they'll actually start to crack down on moderation. They'll actually start to use the power that they should already have. Once they can. But at that point, I mean, you're just racing. It's a race against time. The people who are making these clients are gonna make new ones.
Yeah.
They're gonna make better ones, and they're just gonna catch right back up. It's the nature of this game. When you give people that much freedom, they're going to use it. And
Yeah,
whether
use
it's
it, yeah.
untapped or not, it's how VRChat is. It's the nature of this game.
Yeah,
Which sucks,
I had this
because it can
conversation
be just as
before.
negative as it is
Like, I
positive.
know that they can't do anything until Unity 2018 comes out, and the reason why they're taking so long when it's supposed to come out like 4 months ago is because supposedly there's a bug where if you build a map of terrain or something, I don't know, some bug where they can't do anything until Unity actually updates the engine to support VRChat, and they're waiting on Unity to actually implement it. If they don't, then if they push to 2018 right now, it'll actually crash the game and actually just like fucking blow up your computer or some bullshit like that. So why do that, right? You gotta wait for Unity to actually push this patch to then make sure it works with VRChat. So basically the devs are sitting on their hands and can't do anything until Unity actually does their job. So You know, it's kind of just like we're just a waiting game, but then again, like how much
Yeah,
time do
it's
we
the same as it was
have?
with the 2017 Switch.
Yeah, like it's a big waiting game because it's like, oh, like if this takes too long, will the game actually get banned or like what's gonna happen, right? Like if this takes too long, more people are gonna leave, more people are just gonna keep hating on it and just like say like, ah, screw it, this is taking too long, right? Like how much is too long, right? Because we've already been waiting
Yeah,
months and months and
exactly.
months for something. Like, the average person doesn't have the patience to be like, I'm going to wait exactly 6 months for this game to be updated properly. Because the average person wants it now. And I understand that they can't do it right now, but, like, you know, it's like more people are going to leave every single day. And more of the people that are toxic and negative are just going to keep breeding and coming more and more. Because they know.
Yeah,
Because
exactly.
they know right now, hey man, they can't do anything, bro. I can literally get banned and
Yep,
make a new
and all
account.
the freedom in the world.
And most crashers that I've heard of, most of them have like 10 accounts, and they just fucking, they get banned once, they just switch to the other account and be like, haha, loser. So, yeah.
Yeah, it's a little nasty right now, and it's unfortunate because, like, I have a love-hate relationship with this game, and I always have.
Same.
There's been a lot of things that I love about it, and there's a lot of things I absolutely hate about it. And that's one of them is like the really toxic side of the community. But I've also seen really good sides of the community. And I mean, that's with anything, literally anything. And it's just kind of something, it's more prevalent in some things than it is in others. Like in VR chat, it's died down a lot. I would say personally, it's died down a lot over the last couple months. You hear a lot less about people DDoSing, crashing. I mean, we've had somebody going around ripping avatars like crazy.
Yeah, I heard about that.
And I mean, that's disgusting, but it is what it is. It's they have the power to do it. It's super easy, and people are making and mass producing clients to allow it. That needs to be cucked in 2018. And hopefully it will be. I feel like clients are an absolute bane of this game. Whether they're made to enhance the experience or not, they're breeding grounds for more terrible shit to happen. People pay a lot of money for models. Not everybody does, but people do. And it shouldn't be that easy to just take it. But it is. It's like the Ruby client, where you can look at the last 200 models that were uploaded. Or 500, rather. That's stupid! Because, like, if you want to say, like, you wanted me to dance in your model for you, to do that, you'd either have to upload it to my account, which takes forever. And you have to trade credentials, or you could just set it to public and let me clone it. But now, if you set your avatar to public just for a friend to use it in a private world, all of VR chat just ripped your damn model and everything you paid for is gone. Worthless.
Exactly.
And it's turbo shitty because mine's been ripped like that. My base has been reused in other people's worlds, my base has been sold, and I spent almost a year working on it. I'm still working on it now. And I mean, there's just nothing you can do once that happens. And that, in my opinion, is one of the worst things about VR chat is people marketing it like that. They can steal and sell it, and there's no repercussions whatsoever. There's nothing you can do. The internet. There's too many freedoms, and there's not enough ways to enforce anything. Especially nowadays.
Yeah, I mean, this is definitely some friends that I've had that have avatars been ripped, and there's not much they can do. But like, I guess it's like people come together and like sort of, you know, if someone sees someone else's avatar being stolen, like it sort of gets like posted on Twitter, and everyone's just like get this person, fuck them up, boys, fuck them up, boys. The boys will come see you later. You know what I'm saying? So like. I mean that's like that's not the right way to do it, but I mean what else is there to do honestly? Like I don't know, man.
Exactly. There's only so much we can do,
Maybe
and honestly.
I'm in a different position because I actually own my model, so maybe I can sue some people if I figure it out and get some DMCA
Yeah.
strikes. I could do that. So,
See,
but
me and Chosen have considered doing that if I end up seeing like more of my model and clothing like popping up in worlds and stuff.
yeah.
But it's such a hassle to even have to do all that. You shouldn't even have to be in that situation to begin with. But
Exactly.
we get put in it just because of all the extra freedoms and stuff people have with clients and all that. But
I
it's something
mean,
we deal with and we are very conscious of when we log in every day.
technically speaking, every VR chat player must have an email address. So if someone was to steal my avatar and then try and do whatever, they would just find out their VRChat account, which says their email associate. If it, send them a nice little email and say, hey man, if you keep doing what you're doing, we're gonna sue your ass. And they're gonna be like, oh shit, man. And so, I mean, yeah,
but there just needs to be more, I don't know, more risk for them to do that, because right now it's just kind of like free reign. You can do what you want in this game.
Well, I mean, I think there's only like less than 1% of the avatars are actually like made from scratch, like mine. I think like most people just rip stuff. So like, technically speaking, when someone's avatar gets ripped, they're probably using a stolen asset anyway, and then they're like complaining about their stolen asset from TDA or whatever, and then they're like, so like you're already stealing someone else's stuff, and then you're crying that someone else is just then stealing yours. So you can't really do anything. But if it's something like mine, then it's a different story. So
you can, if you actually go to that length to have something commissioned and made, like, actually commissioned, like, made from cubes, not pulled from somebody else's avatar, you have that backing, which helps tremendously. But not everybody does that.
Of course not.
And, I mean, that's going to be an issue for everybody else that's in that situation. I mean, that's... It kind of is what it is. It's a risk that you take playing online. People suck. Well, everywhere on the internet.
I mean, there's always things you can do to counter it. You can always just use, like, a public avatar you just don't care about in publics and or whatever.
That's what I do.
And, I mean, every time I hear about Crasher or Stealer or whatever, it's always in either A, publics, or Friends Plus. That's
Friends
basically
Plus is public.
It.
Don't at me.
True. I mean, the amount of times where I've been in a Friends Plus and it's okay for a bit, and then eventually just devolves into like Crashers getting into a lobby because someone's dumb and adds a bunch of random people. Because, like, I'm going to be honest with you here. Stream sniping this game is literally easy. Okay? All you have to do is you got to watch a streamer. If they're in a room of 20 people, you literally look at all the nameplates and just friend request every single one of them. If one person adds you, you're now access to the lobby. It's that easy.
Yeah, or they can just put in the world ID if you're in...
Or use the ID, if you know how to do that, but most people don't. But most people just add people and just be like... Because, like, most people are going to be like, oh my god, a new friend! Okay, accept, I guess.
Yep.
And then it's like, who's this guy?
I have a friends list miles long, specifically for that reason. Or a list of friend requests, rather. Because, I mean, if I have to meet the person several times before I actually end up accepting it.
Yeah, man.
And there's just a lot of risks that come with that, and I'm aware of that now. So I try to play it as safe as possible, but still be social in this game, because that's what it's meant for. Mm-hmm. I hate having to lock myself away in private worlds. It sucks. It takes the social out of this game, which is what it was even played for.
Mm-hmm. We'll start taking some questions from the chat. So if anyone has any questions from my chat or your chat, we'll start taking them. I have a statement here from Asunny. I mean, it's an ongoing thing, to be honest, and VRChat says they're going to take care of it, but we all know that's not going to happen anytime soon, and a public world is just a roll of the dice kind of thing. If you're lucky, then the lobby
really
is fun,
is.
But if it's not, it's toxic. That's why I'm so iffy on coming back to VRChat. It's the same thing for me. I don't really go to public. I want to go to public, so like how I went to 2 years ago, but I know it's not going to be the same experience. Either I have to find like very, very unpopular worlds, and then maybe find a decent human being, or I just do it off stream. Like most of the times I just play I go to Publix off stream. I use a normal, like, I don't even give a care, like, avatar, like just like a random avatar that's public.
Yeah.
So if someone wants to steal it, it'd just be like, okay, you just cloned this really public avatar nobody cares about. So
yeah.
And even then that point, like, I still, like, it's, I don't know, it's still hard to like find people that want to talk or something, because most people are just like, fuck off, I'm staring at the mirror, what do you want? And so it's like people are like really like anti-social or some
so
shit.
True.
It's like, what happened, man? This is a social game.
I hate
dude.
It.
It's like, why can't you just
want
to talk
to dance
me,
in public and,
it's
like,
different
try to
it's different
it.
If I was memeing or being toxic or shitty in general. I'm just like talking. I'm like, hey, what's going on, dude? They're like, leave me alone, don't talk to me. I'm like, okay, dude, like, calm down.
Yeah, it sucked, man. VRChat's not what it used to be at all. It's not even relatively close. It's a hollow shell of what it was. But even in that, it can still be enjoyable. Like, I have more fun dancing, whether it be by myself or with friends, or sometimes in public worlds. I'll go to a public world and, you know, 9 times out of 10, maybe more than that, I get such a good reaction from people when I'm dancing. Like, there could be people playing this shitty loud music or, you know, just being assholes in the background. And I go upstairs in a pug or something and I start dancing, and then everybody just crowds around. And then next thing you know, everybody's just talking, having a good time. They're doing what they should have been doing originally. Talking, hanging out, having a good time. And it just takes some things like that to try to, like, bring everybody together. But so many people get on here just looking to start shit because they can. It's the internet.
Yeah, when you know
the Warriors, but with VR.
Yeah, I mean, if you play VR chat and you know that, like, oh, if I do something bad, I'm not gonna get banned. Then, like, it just feeds into that mentality. It's like, well, there's no repercussions, right? It's just like real life, where if I steal something from a store, I know I have a chance of going to jail, having to pay a fine, all this shit. That's real life. But when you play a video game, you're just like, oh, I can shit talk these people and steal their avatars and laugh at them, and I will not get banned. And even if I did, I'd just make a new account. Wow, that's so easy. It's not like there's a VAC system in VR chat where it's just like, if you get banned, you're fucking donezo. It's not like you have to, it's not like Counter-Strike Source, or sorry, not CSGO, where if you cheat in the game, you have to buy the game again. You're done. You have to make a whole new Steam account, and then you have to buy the game again. And then Gaben's like, hey, give me money again, idiot.
Yeah.
So it's not like that. VRChat's a free game, and I understand this game will probably never be paid for. I understand that it can't because of all the stolen and random shit.
Yeah, but it can never be endorsed by anything.
So, I don't know, it's very tough for them to figure out ways to, you know, go around this and fix the issue, but I guess the only way is to wait until 2018, whenever Unity implements the patch, and then they can actually push this game to 2018 and then have better security systems. But let's be real here, those security systems are probably going to be breached anyway. Eventually,
yeah,
it always ends up happening.
It'll be a temporary solution.
Yeah, it'll be a temporary solution, so we'll have to see. What I'm really hoping for, maybe I'm being a bit of a pessimistic towards VRChat, but I'm more optimistic for a new type of VR social game. Like, that's like VRChat, but already has these fixes. Like, maybe you have to pay 20 bucks to play it, or it has, or like, you know, for example, Half-Life Alyx is going to come out on Monday or Tuesday, right, on the 23rd. Mm-hmm. And let's say someone's going to take that Half-Life engine, Half-Life Alyx, Source 2, and they can make their own social game, and it'll be run for the Steam Workshop. So that means that if you get banned, you're VAC banned, and that means it's a lot harder to get around that. And if you're a bad person,
exactly,
it's all endorsed by Valve, and I'm pretty sure Gaben's going to fucking ban your ass if you're doing something malicious in their little social game they're making. So just think of, like,
I feel like
Gears
something
Mod.
Will come along and replace VRChat. Something will be the nail in the coffin for this game.
Yeah.
It'll never die. It's just not going to happen. But it won't be the VR social game anymore at some point. Maybe not soon, but I do feel like something will come along and take over. I mean, big streamers in VR chat are disappearing, and new ones will take their spot, and then they disappear.
Yeah,
too.
You
like,
mean.
There's ongoing bans. They're cracking down on more of the stuff, and it's like, okay, they're paying more attention to this game. It's not even a highly watched game. Like, there's nobody Unity games like 7 Days to Die that has an average higher viewer count than VRChat. Our numbers during the day are like 2K, maybe.
Yeah.
Altogether. And then at like our time right now, I'd say like midnight our time, it's like 2.5, 3K, because you have a lot of like the big streamers on the other side of the planet who have bigger audiences and stuff. But VR chat's just not a big thing. And it makes it that much easier for them to just flick it off and be like, bye, can't stream this anymore. And then that kneecaps a lot of people. Like,
just get Suva.
Streaming is how I can hang out with so many people. Suva.
Yeah, man. It means you can take your VRChat avatar, and now you can play any video game. Your avatar is this, like, your, like,
oh, yeah,
it's
yeah.
your webcam
I use
thing.
All the time.
Yeah.
Suva is a gift from gods. I love Griba for that thing.
I think
there's stuff like that. Like, you can pull your VRChat stream life, I guess, out of VRChat and still take it other places with you. Like, you can take that personality to other things now. That's like this whole VTuber thing that's just blown up and everybody's shoving it in their titles now.
Mm-hmm.
It fits because you're not tied to VRChat to use your OC. your persona, whatever it might be for you. And without that anchor anymore, I mean, people are going to start going off and doing their own thing. I've seen a lot of the bigger VR chat streamers doing that. They're distancing themselves a little bit and going off and doing more things. And eventually, I mean, this might just become a backseat thing for them.
Yeah, I agree with that. There's many VR chat streamers or people that started with VR chat and then they move on to other games and they grow their audience and collaborate with people. I think a lot of people that I know just say that they're embarrassed to play VR chat or like, because when you talk to like any big streamer, I'm talking about like people with thousands of viewers on Twitch or 10,000, anytime that someone, any streamer thinks of VR chat, they're like, oh, that's the lewd game where the people wear no clothes and they fuck each other.
Yes, exactly.
That's what most people say. And I mean, they're not wrong in a sense, but like, it's a very big...
But they're also not right.
Yeah, it's kind of like it's kind of like the stereotype, right? Like VR chat, me, you, and I are just sitting here having a good conversation. Like that's what VR chat should be about, just having a good time with your friends. But the problem is that doesn't nobody cares about the good stuff. Oh, everybody, whenever something is brought up, it's people always talk about the negative things about something. The good, if you talk about the good stuff, nobody cares. It's always, oh, there's something wrong with this game. Well, there's something wrong with this community. So that's what always gets known is the negativity. Yeah.
Yeah.
Especially,
and it sucks to see that because this game does a lot. If you really think about it, VR chat is a home for the broken. Most of the player base that I've met, whether it be in streams, people that just watch VR chat, people that play VR chat, a lot of them have issues. I do. I know a lot of people do. They have social anxiety. They have depression, gender dysphoria, all kinds of things that might make them, you know, like shut in IRL. They can come in VR chat and they can be themselves and not have to worry about anything. And over time, that builds confidence. A year and a half ago, you wouldn't catch me dead dancing. There's no way I would have ever danced. And now I've danced in front of crowds of 100 plus people IRL. Like, it's just, it's crazy how much confidence and stuff this game can give you. Without you even noticing it. Social skills can be built up a lot. Like, it's... Oh God, what's the word, man? I don't know. This game just helps a lot of people in a lot of ways.
Self-esteem?
And whether it be passive or them using VR chat to feel better, which is where you can kind of cross into that... You come to this fork in the road where it's like you're using VR chat to feel better, right? It's working. You either go off and do good things, IRL, and you know the self-esteem boost helps you, or you get stuck in VR and you feel like you're only worth a damn if you're in VR chat as, you know, an anime girl or a wolf boy with a crasher avatar. It's like, it's still you no matter what, whether you're hiding behind an avatar or not. It's still you that's changing as a person. I've become a lot more open. I've become a lot more confident in what I do. I don't hate everything I do anymore because of stuff like this and the good ass people that are in this community. There are some unbelievably good people here, like mind-blowing. It's crazy.
Yeah, some people have raised,
but it's
literally
all just so overshadowed,
tens of thousands of dollars for charity, and it gets overshadowed. Nobody reads about that. They don't hear about like the stuff that like Fizzy just raised like $20,000 for charity. Like, no one hears about that. Everyone just cares about, oh, yeah, there's just some guy fucking another guy in a public role. Hell yeah, gamers.
Yeah.
That's, like, all people care about. It's like, bro, this guy literally raised money for charity. Like, what?
Yeah. Like, ugh.
All I'm saying is I'm waiting for Source 2. I'm waiting for somebody to take that engine, make Garry's Mod 2. Because you can, like, make dedicated servers. So, like, let's say I own a server, right? Hypothetically, let's say VRChat has a server system, and I own my own server, and I can set the rules to whatever I want. If someone's bad, they're gonzo. They're donezo for my world, my server. They're gone forever, and that would make it an interesting experience. Because then it's like, if you're banned from one server, you might be banned from 100 servers, and now you can't play anywhere except for all these other shitty toxic people. So it's
and
just
that
like,
would eliminate so many issues, and the servers would still, in theory, be big enough for people to still be as social as they want. But that doesn't work because VR chat uses other servers, not their own, like Amazon, I believe.
Yeah.
But if they had their own system for that, this game would be so infinitely better off. And if people had to pay to run servers, you know people would. It's not
Yeah.
like that everybody on here is just like, you can't afford anything or something. There's people on here who would run that. And it would monetize some of VR chat. It would be its own internal monetization to help support itself, for one. And two, it would fix so many of the issues with shitty people. You know, like other server issues, clients would get kneecapped. So many good things would come from that, but I just don't see it really happening unless they somehow shove themselves into that position. Maybe they will at some point, but it's a bit of a stretch for me to say that, honestly.
Yeah, we'll have
Wishful
to see.
thinking.
We'll take some more questions from the chat. We're about to wrap this up. Whoops. The city says Unreal Engine is the future, not Garry's Mod. Well, I mean, the Unreal Engine is a good engine, but I just don't see VRChat just switching from one major engine to another. I just don't see that happening ever. I'm going to be 100% honest with you. VRChat's not going to be like, let's switch from using Unity to the Unreal Engine because we felt like that's not going to happen. They're not going
to
do
that
shit.
They would have to
shit.
Rebuild
the whole.
Everything.
Yeah, they would have to literally make the whole game again. They're not going to do that, dude. They're not a freaking billion-dollar company, and they don't have any. They barely can function as it is. They're not going to do that. That's
Yeah.
for other social games, man. That's for some other indie company to do. Make a whole new VR chat. So.
Yeah. Somebody will do it.
VRChat needs
along.
something
They'll
like
do it.
IP
VRChat
bans.
even better.
I mean, we already discussed this, but I mean,
IP bans are irrelevant.
they're
It's so
irrelevant,
easy
dude.
to
In
get around
20, dude, you ever know what a VPN is, dude? You know what NordVPN is, bro? Come on, dude. Like anybody
You can
who's,
just reset your IP with your router
that,
nowadays.
or that too,
Almost all ISPs allow you to.
Yeah, so you
like
can
that's
just.
how I got out of getting DDoSed was doing that. It's just I had to go get a new router and new, you know, internet service provider, but. Like, all you have to do is just reset the router, let it reboot your IP,
Exactly.
you have an all new one. Next thing you know, you're out of trouble, and you're home free to just go back and start wreaking havoc again.
See, in another IP, I mean, it's not, like I just said, it's not that hard to make it a new IP address. It's like,
yeah.
Like, the thing is, like, it's different if it was like dedicated servers, then maybe like actually impact you, or if you actually had to pay for this game, which you couldn't. But hypothetically, if you had to pay another $20, someone ain't gonna get keep getting banned paying $20. I'm gonna be honest with you here. The average person's
yeah,
gonna be
exactly.
like,
they're gonna be like, all right,
all right,
too
fuck
much.
it, dude. $100 to play this game for the sixth time. Shit, brother. Damn.
Yeah, brother.
And then the devs
Yeah.
would just be laughing because they'd be like, hey, you paid all this money and you're still getting banned every single time, idiot. But that won't happen because they can't sell this game. But...
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, I think we'll wrap this up here. So if you, I'll put the camera on you if you want to say anything. Any last minute thoughts? Anything you want to shout out? Anything you're working on? You know, this is the time to plug, basically. If you want to.
Well, let's see here. You know what? One thing I did want to touch on with,
okay.
Since. I'm assuming we both have a relatively large audience right now. We can get more kind of voices in on this whole thing. Coronavirus. COVID-19.
Yeah.
A lot of people are on lockdown. I just, as of today, I'm unemployed now.
Mm-hmm.
I mentioned earlier I got this really good job going, and we finally met our fate, I guess. Shut down until further notice, and a lot of people are going through some really hard times that fit in. I want to know how many of people in my chat or your chat or in you yourself, how are things affecting you guys right now? How many of you are on like a lockdown or unemployed now? Things just kind of going sideways.
For me, my school has, you know, I'm in college, so they not letting anyone. I think you can still go to college, but classes are canceled, so a lot of them are all online. My classes are online. I'm fine. I just have to do all my homework online, take my tests online, so we're fine on that front. I don't go back to school until May, until further notice. They might cancel the next semester. I don't know, but that's for me. I haven't really like left the house in days. I mean, my dad's the one who buys the groceries and all that stuff, and he's telling me all the stories about
yeah.
how he's like, fucking, you can't buy soap and like. Just,
yeah,
you
it's
know,
wild.
Yeah, it's like, and there's like no traffic because everyone's staying indoors, self isolating. I think that's like the general consensus is a lot of people are just self-isolating, and hopefully I'm hoping that most people have the money to buy groceries and be safe. I know a
Yeah,
lot of people are getting
I
laid
definitely
off from
agree.
work, and the government, I'm from Canada, so the government's basically saying like 2 to 3 weeks you'll get like money to like pay for
Yeah.
groceries or something. I don't know, something like that. But if it depends on if you're working or not. If you're working and you have unemployment insurance, then you're fine. But if you don't have that, then you're gonna have to like, I don't know, like something to do with taxes and shit. I don't know, the whole
Yeah,
spiel,
and
but
it's becoming a
yeah.
really big mess. Like, I think that the virus itself is not the true threat, honestly speaking. It's the virus that'll come and go. We've had them happen plenty of times in the past, even in the recent past. I think the thing that everybody is just kind of letting go over the head is you can't hide from the economic downfall of this. In the United States right now, our stock market has crashed harder basically ever than it has. It hasn't been this bad since the Cold War.
Yeah, man.
And just in 2008, we had a small recession, and it took 3 years to bounce back. This is like a tactical nuke. And 2008 was a firecracker.
Just print some more
Like, it
money,
could take
bro.
10 years for this, honestly. Just fix it.
Just print more money, dude. What do you mean? I'm just kidding. That's like a really stupid
Yeah,
take.
shit.
Just say. Spearmint says I'm doing great because oil and gas manufacturing doesn't shut down due to the considering under national security assets. Yeah, Spearmint is a senior engineer for oil and gas. So some people are fine, like some people are still working. Like if I guess if you're like a news reporter, you
Yeah.
ain't gonna lose a job. You just sit there and talk about
Yeah.
COVID-19 every day, you know what I'm saying? Like there's definitely some
Yeah.
jobs and stuff.
Today, COVID-19.
I think a lot of the people who are suffering are probably people who are like working re like restaurants, for example, because they depend on tips. And if people don't come in to like buy food, which they can't now, then they're fucked. So they, a lot of people are losing jobs for that. There's some people are still flying, like I guess like the postal people and stuff. If you're working like McDonald's, you're still fine because technically they allow takeout in
Yeah,
Canada.
they'll let the drive-through go.
Yeah, drive-through is
That's
fine.
the most we have here. But there's even talks now about shutting those down altogether.
Oh
And
shit, dude. How are you gonna
I
get my
feel
food,
like
bro?
the big mistake was the initial overreaction of it. The mass hysteria and panic is what really fucked everything up from the start. People panic buying is putting, like, people are going and buying like 13 gallons of milk. And it's like,
I need the milk.
why? It's gonna go bad. Like, there's people out there who now won't have anything
Toilet paper only
because
doesn't
you're
go
an
bad.
asshole. And one of the, yeah, that's true. Now, see, I feel a certain type of way about the people who hoarded the toilet paper. I hope y'all go first. But,
Damn.
like,
Steal your
it's.
toilet paper, bro.
People should be more considerate about other people, especially in times like this. But it's
Bro.
kind of not happening.
Someone.
Like, you're gonna start seeing the true colors of people
When I
soon.
was in school, last. What was it, last Friday? No. Yeah? Last Friday, I think? I don't remember now. But anyway, the teacher, I was there. The teacher told me, like, and I went to the bathroom. Like someone stole all the toilet paper, like all the stalls and all the hand sanitizer and shit around my college. And we're
Wow.
like, what the fuck? Cause this is like when there's like less than like maybe like 50, no, less than like 50 people infected in Canada. Like the people are already stealing shit. And I'm just like,
Yeah.
what the fuck? And then that was the
See,
last
that's what
day.
I'm so worried about here. With so many people unemployed, and America already has its fancy little crime rate, which is mucho grande. It's only going to get worse from here, I think. Not in regards to the actual virus itself, but to the people who are straining. Like, people are going to do what they have to do to feed their family, whether it's steal from someone who has something they don't, or even worse. And that's something that's completely out of control and up to time, honestly. If this goes on for months like they're saying it might, it's bad news bears for a lot of countries. If they
True.
resolve it soon, we might be able to bounce back from it before it gets too worse, like too far gone. But that
Yeah.
window is closing really, really, really fast.
Yeah, but we still all play VRChat and get drunk every day in the Void Club and not get infected.
Gang
Hey,
gang, gang, that's
gang.
what's
Let's
up.
go. Let's get
That's what I'm
drunk.
in here.
Woo woo.
All
Let's
right, well,
go, dude.
minus the drunk part. I'm just gonna come in here and dance and
Okay,
hang out
just
with
dance. Yeah,
homies, and you know,
hey, you know what I
give
mean?
a little,
Hey, gamers,
little smooch or
pick up
something.
some Oculus Quest, some Oculus Rift S. Get your VR, play VR chat. You won't get infected because you're literally sitting in your room having a good time. You've no social distancing in the VR chat. You literally talk to all the people, man. Hey, gang, gang, let's go.
Yay,
Yeah,
yay!
let's go. A five head. Hey, just play VR chat, bro. Just play some video games, bro. Just play your Animal Crossing New Horizons, bro. Just came out earlier today or whatever, bro. Just
Animal
play that shit, dude.
Crossing, oh god.
Play your Animal
I've seen
Crossing,
so
dude. Play
many
your
tweets on
Doom,
that
dude.
today.
Listen, dude. Just play Doom and pretend it's like the coronavirus, dude. And you just fucking Doom
No, no,
guy.
no,
You
no,
just
no.
go.
Play Doom in VR chat.
Oh, yeah. Play
Because
Doom in
there's the
VR
world
chat.
for it. There you go.
Yeah. Us gamers will survive, dude, because we don't go outside anyway.
Exactly. We're fine.
Yeah.
Although I'm very upset that car season's getting canceled. That makes me big upset. But
Yeah, all the
what
sports
can I
are
do?
canceled, dude. What the fuck, dude? What am I supposed to do? Watching the TV cartoons? I'm watching SpongeBob all day. What the hell, man?
Heck! It's
Damn
game over
it.
for us, buddy. I guess we're
Anyway.
just gonna have to watch anime girls dance.
Yep. Well, anyway, I think we'll wrap it up. So, thank you so much, Genocide, for stopping by and coming again for this interview. I really appreciate it, my good friend. I'm your host, Owen Rebel. It's my talk show, Late Night with Rebel. And, yeah, thank you so much. And before you go, we'll take a selfie, my man. Yeah. Just like last time. Put it on the wall. Easy clap.
That is a big need. We're gonna have two pictures back there now.
Yeah, I mean, there's multiple
Thank
people.
y'all for watching me and for watching
Yeah.
Rebel. It's been a pleasure coming back here just to BS with you again for a while.
Of course,
It
man.
it's been nice. I don't do anything fancy like he does. I just dance on stream and hang out and, stuff like that. I do a lot of like hip hop dancing, break dance, stuff like that. But the real talent is this guy right here. Absolute unit.
Thanks. I appreciate it.
You're too sweet.
I'm just no, you're the real town. You can actually dance. I'm just the guy who talks here and sounds like a weirdo. He's just like, what's going on in VR chat today? And interview people. I don't know. 120 interviews, my man. That's what I've been doing.
120.
Yeah, I'm an old man.
I'm
Anyway.
an old man.
Hey, that's what I feel like every day.
I feel
Anyway.
that.
Oh no, what was that? Something bad. I opened up like a text file. Oh shit! Wait, what did I do? Oh god.
Yo,
Sorry.
my text files are on my desktop too.
Yeah, I accidentally opened something. My bad. Anyway, we'll take a selfie. Ugh. Oh, I gotta stand up.
Wasn't on stream, that'd be pretty monk-ass to be
No, it
honest.
wasn't on stream. It's just I have to like disable my camera stuff, and I do it by using Oculus Dash. Yeah, I just click the wrong buttons. It happens.
All right. Hold on, let me see here.
Wan Wan, dude.
Guan
Wan Wan.
Guan.
Taiwan number one.
Number
Oh,
one.
yeah, man. Bro, why you have to be so tall, man? Bro.
You were taller than me last time.
My
There's actually
avatar.
a clip of me getting scared by you being taller than me.
Oh yeah. I made my avatar
So
five
now I
foot
get to be
eight.
like.
Oh, I like it when a strong woman holds me. Alright,
Hey.
alright. Ooh. Ooh. Take two. Always take two, gamers. Pro tip. Alright, take three, actually. I lied. Oh my god, I'm
Hey,
feeling
that's
it.
that
I
homie
feel.
stuff right there.
Oh, homie
Whoa.
stuff. Whoa.
Oh.
Oh god. I'm
Now
feeling it, Mr. Krabs.
you got some jiggly thighs there, but I'm feeling it, Mr. Krabs.
Sure do.
You
Sure
know what you
do.
should do? You
What?
should let me dance for you.
Hold on one second. My,
Hold on one second.
No, it's because I'm. Oh fuck. My, cable's stuck on my chair, so. I kind of want to fix that real quick before
Wait, so do
you
you have
get.
the Index headset right now?
No.
Or
It's coming tomorrow.
you just ordered it all?
I just
Okay.
ordered it last week. It's coming
you have
tomorrow.
The Vive right now, don't you?
Nope. Oculus Rift, my man. Hybrid
oh,
setup,
really?
Bro.
Like
this
headset's OG Rift?
The OG.
Oh yeah, OG Rift was better, TBH.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man. All right, I'm ready.
Oh. Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, let me set up my camera.
You guys ready for this? This is the dance, just for me. You guys are just gonna watch.
Just for you.
Yeah.
For being a sweetheart.
Oh, thanks.
All right. Yeah.
Damn. Oh, I'm getting a little nervous, a little flustered. I've never been with a real woman before. Oh, jeez. Hope my mom doesn't come in and see me like this, sitting here. Oh, God. Oh, man. My legs are a bit weird. Let me fix that real quick. Oh. Oh, God. Almost crashed. Almost broke myself. Hold on. While he's doing that, I'll fix myself because I'm slightly like tilted. Like tilted towers. Here we go. Good enough. Listen, dude, that's in your wildest dreams you think that's going to happen, bro. That's the secret. Why are you exposing me like that? But yes. Half-Life Alyx. Yeah, it comes out on, I think, Monday, the 23rd, so hopefully I get my index set up tomorrow. You have a good time. Then I can move my fingers.
Alright.
Yeah.
You don't kiss her with your eyes closed. I bet you're still walking on a tightrope. Miss me so much, you've been going psycho. You ain't gotta say it, baby, I know. It's a thin line between all this love and hate. And if you switch sides, you're gonna have to claim a place. So baby, this time you're gonna have to steal your fate. Yeah, baby, this time you're gonna have to steal your fate. And tell me how you hate me, still trying to replace me.
Trash and you can easily replace me. Tell me that I'm strung out, wasted on a daily. Probably cause there's no one around me numbing all my pain. Probably cause there's no umbrella to shield me from all the rain. Probably because you're the one playing the mind game. You hate me because I don't let you play the mind game. They give me my grace and damage my brain. Take me, break me, easily replace me. Hopefully you see it clear, hopefully it's HD. Bet you wonder why the few months I've been spacey. In your head I sing.
And tell me how you hate me. Still tryna replace me. Chase me, chase me. Tell me how you hate me. Replace me, replace me. Wish you never hated me. Lies, tell me lies, baby. Tell me how you hate me. If you switch sides, you're gonna have to claim your place. So baby, this time you're gonna have to steal your fate. Yeah, baby, this time you're gonna have to steal your fate. And tell me how you hate me. Tell me how you hate me.
my goodness. Take all my money, man. Just